Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today is the first day for developing the banking system using Java. First, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the database first. So go to the localhost php myadmin, here new. Here I'm going to create the bank database as something name, HS Bank. This is I just create the name as HS Bank for my database. Click create. Right, now my database has been created, HS Bank. Now he asked for create the table, so we have to create the table for customers. First I'm going to create the table for customer table. It asks that how many columns we need. We need only 8 columns. Right. Now here we have to create the columns for the customer table. So your first one should be ID. This one should be 11. It should be primary with auto increment. This is auto increment. Now another one for the cust ID. This is the customer ID. The customer ID. Here we have to create as 255. This should be voucher, because customer ID I am going to enter as a text plus numeric value, so that I have put as voucher. The example we have to write like this, so you have to easily understood this concept. Customer ID we have to enter as CS001, like that. So this should be text, this should be numbers. So if we have entered both, okay, right, that's why I enter like this. After that I am entering the first name, last name, street, city, branch, so here enter as a phone number. Finally we have phone number. This is the things we are required to enter the customer table for the database. So click save button. This is your structure of the customer table. After that I am going to create the account table. So again click new, select the database here. Here I am going to first determine how many columns we need. We need 5 columns, and here I am going to enter the name as table name as account. Click go. First one should be ID 11, primary, auto increment. Second one should be cust ID. Cust ID here and select as voucher. Here account type, not cust ID, first one the account ID, second one is the account ID, sorry. This one should be voucher. Third one should be cust ID, customer ID. This should be voucher. This one should be account type. Account type, let's select as voucher. Final one should be balance. Balance should be int, double characters. Right. This is the columns names: ID, account ID, customer ID, account type and balance. The customer ID, the same thing is coming here, right? Customer ID, ID. This is the same ID store in this table, account table, called as foreign key. This is the primary key. This is a foreign key, right? Concept. Let's click save. Right, that's the thing we have to do. Right. Now he created two tables. One is an account table. Another one is a customer table. Two tables we have completed successfully. Now what I am going to do is I am going to create the project here. First I am going to go to the browser, and here we have to go to the Google browser. Here we have to download the MySQL connector for Java. MySQL connector for Java. It's bring to the links like this. Here you have to select the first link, MySQL download connector J, this one. If you click this, it goes to the website. Look like this. Here you have to go below. Here platform independent zip, this one. There will be the link to download. You just click on this link. This goes to another page. Here if you like, you can log in and sign up for this particular website. So now you no need, you just want to download the MySQL connector only. So you just click on this link, no thanks, just start my download. If you click this link, your download has been started for downloading here. If you click this link here, it's starting for downloading the MySQL connector for Java, right? This is the way you have to download the MySQL connector. Now I already download this connector into my machine. I just cancel the things, right? Now if you download the MySQL connector, after that go to the NetBeans. This is the NetBeans. Now go file, new project, Java application. Next, here you have to give the name for the your bank. Now I just give the bank name as HS Bank. This is a name. Main method, you have to, here you have to uncheck this one. Click finish. Now here you have a bank. Your project has been created successfully, HS Bank. Now here there will be the library. Here you have to import the library over here. So how to import the MySQL connector on this library? You just click on this, click the library and right click, properties, here add jar button. Click on this add jar button. Here you have to give the MySQL connector here. So where you download the MySQL connector in your local computer, you have to go to that folder, MySQL connector folder. Okay, this is the folder. If it is, when you download that download the MySQL connector, the file should be come zip file. You have to extract them. After that you have to get the normal file look like this. MySQL connector file look like this. If you don't know how to extract the things, just I show you that stuff as well. Here this one. When you download the file, it's look like this, this format. Here MySQL connector for Java. Here the folder look like, when you download in your local machine, this folder look like this. You just right click, and if you right click and extract the file, here you go, here MySQL connector. Here this one, right click, and extract out, the file should be extracted. If you click this one, the file should be extracted. Your machine. Okay, I already extracted, so that I don't need to extract again. So after that, but after extract the file, you have to go to the libraries, right click. This is your project, libraries, right click, add jar folder. Here you have to go to the folder, MySQL connector folder. This one, the folder, double click on this. You have to find the MySQL, these two relevant file. This would be essential, these two file for in order to connect MySQL database and NetBeans. You just select the two files, control alt control key, and select this both and open it. It's open it. You have to check it is successfully added or not. Again click on the library expand, you can check it's added successfully. I hope you guys you understood the stuff so far. In my next tutorial I will continue the customer form. If you like my channel, please subscribe me. Thank you for watching.